Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to talk about ways to remember and learn the different relationships of the six basic trigonometric functions. All right, let's go ahead and begin with a drawing. And this drawing is going to be the unit circle. So here we're going to draw in our coordinate plane. And then I'm going to put a circle on the plane. This is the unit circle. And then let's change color to show some of the things we need to talk about. Let's say we have an arbitrary point here. We have a radius going out to that point. This radius is going to be 1. And then we're going to draw in a vertical. And that vertical creates a right angle. All right, from the origin to the point here is going to have a length of x. From the point up here straight down is going to have a length of y. So that means that the coordinates for this point have to be xy. And let's put theta in here to show the angle that's made with the radius and the x-axis. Let's go ahead and add in the x and y axis as well. So here's our x, and then here's our y. All right, we have a right triangle. And we're going to talk about the basic trig functions that are the that are based on the ratios of the sides of this right triangle. So let's begin with let's start with cosine. So we'll say cosine theta. All right, when we talk about cosine is going to be the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So in this case, it's going to be x over 1. And that x over 1 just simplifies down to x. So here we see that cosine theta is the same thing as x. And if you've watched previous videos, you've seen that I said that that first coordinate corresponds to cosine. Now let's go ahead and do sine of theta. All right, the sine of theta is going to be the opposite over the hypotenuse. In this case, it's going to be y over 1. And in this case, the that simplifies down to just y. And again, we see that sine theta is the same as y. So I know that y is the same thing as sine. Another thing I want to say here too is that this line segment here from the origin to the outer edge of the circle, that's also called r. So here I'm going to say that in this particular example, that the radius is equal to r. And we could also say that if I were to rewrite this cosine theta, I could say that cosine theta is the same thing as x over r. But in our case, we keep the x. We see the radius is 1, so it still comes out to be 1. If I were to do that with sine theta is y over r. Again, the value for r is 1. The value for the numerator is y, which still comes out to be y. All right, now let's go ahead and go to tangent of theta. All right, when we talk about tangent is going to be the opposite over the adjacent. So tangent is y over x. Tangent is also can be seen as sine theta over cosine theta. And again, that relates back to what we just talked about, where y relates to sine and x relates to cosine. Now let's take a look at the inverses of these. So if I have 1 over cosine theta, that is the same thing as secant theta. And again, if we look at the ratio, it's normally x over r, but we're going to flip it. So now it's really r over x. If we did 1 over sine theta, Well, the inverse of sine theta is cosecant theta. And again, if we flipped it, it started off as y over r, but then it will be r over y. And let's do the same thing with tangent. So 1 over tangent theta is the same thing as cotangent theta. And cotangent, again, tangent starts off as y over x. We're going to flip it to be x over y. And that's also seen as cosine theta over sine theta. All right, so this here are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 basic trigonometric functions, and I want to add in here just a little bit about the Pythagorean identities, right? The first Pythagorean identity would be sine squared x plus cosine squared x is equal to 1. A way to remember to derive the others would be to divide this by sine squared. So let me just rewrite what I have here. So let's rewrite the sine squared x plus cosine squared x equals 1. And I'm going to divide each one of these terms by sine squared x. All right, well, when the numerator and denominator are exactly the same, we know that results to just being 1. Here I have a cosine squared over sine squared. If we look back, cosine over sine is cotangent, but these are squared, so it's just going to be cotangent squared. Well, cotangent squared x. And then 1 over sine squared x, well, if it's 1 over sine, it's cosecant. So, well, because it's squared, it's going to be cosecant squared. And in this case, x. So let me just highlight these. So this here would be first Pythagorean identity. This here is the second Pythagorean identity. And I'm going to squeeze in the third Pythagorean identity right over here. Again, we're going to start off with this base Pythagorean identity, which what I believe is the easiest one to remember, which is the sine squared x plus cosine squared x is equal to 1. We divided everything by sine squared in this first, well, in this example here. Now we're going to divide everything by cosine squared. Again, let's switch color. Let's go to green. So each term is going to be divided by cosine squared x. Cosine squared x. Now I have sine squared over cosine squared. If we go back, sine over cosine is the same thing as tangent. The only thing missing is that it's squared. So this here is actually tangent squared x. Plus, the numerator and denominator are exactly the same. So we know that resolves down to 1. And then here we have 1 over cosine squared x. Here when we have 1 over cosine, we see that secant. But because it's squared, we're going to write it as secant squared x. All right, so this here is a quick video on the 6 basic trigonometric functions. And then I also showed how to remember and derive the remaining 3 Pythagorean identities. There are many more identities. We're just keeping it simple in this particular video. I want to thank you again for watching the video. By ajspeller.com. Please visit the website and also our YouTube and Facebook pages. Thank you again for watching.